Big breaking story right now is that the Supreme Court has shifted trial in five cases, in all five cases, out of Uttar Pradesh. Now, that's the big breaking story coming out of the Supreme Court at this point. Now, the Supreme Court has also said that the investigation into the accident case, the accident that took place in Rai Bareli, where the truck mowed into the rape survivor's car, that is going to be expedited in 7 days. Remember, the CBI had asked for a month to complete that probe. The Supreme Court isn't having any of that. The Supreme Court orders finish that probe in 7 days. If further time is required, then one more week can be given, is what the court has said. But the much bigger point and the huge embarrassment for the Uttar Pradesh government is that the Supreme Court has felt that all five cases now must be shifted out of the state in order for justice to be served. And that is an enormous indictment on the justice system, the law and order system in Uttar Pradesh. Now, Alok, the big breaking story right now, you know, can there be a bigger indictment really for the Adityanath government and indeed the entire justice system in the state?
There cannot be, there cannot be. And just to recapitulate what has happened, the Supreme Court has transferred the trial in all cases, in all the cases related to this gang rape survivor and
Remind
what has happened to her
cases,
in the last year.
Alok.
All of them have been... Well, yes. See, all the cases, I'll tell you the main cases there are two main cases that we need to consider. One of those cases is the death of the father of this girl in judicial custody. If you remember, what had happened last year around April was that the father of the girl was beaten up by Sengar's brother and his men. And after being beaten up, he was the one who was sent to jail because the police filed an FIR against him saying that he was the one intimidating Sengar's brother and his men with a gun. So imagine this, Ankita. Your father gets beaten up. I mean, anyone's father gets beaten up. And then there's a case against that person saying that he was the one trying to intimidate. Such was the clout of Sengar and such was the submissiveness of the Uttar Pradesh police that they went ahead and filed an FIR against the father. The father was sent to jail. He was not taken to a super speciality hospital. He was not taken anywhere. He had grievous injuries. He kept on telling them, ki bhaiya, mujhe chot lagi hai, mujhe hospital le jao. By the time they took him to hospital, he was half dead and then he died. After he died, the gang rape survivor and her family came here to Lucknow, tried to immolate themselves in front of the home of Yogi Adityanath, who was the chief minister. And after that, after they did all this, then there was an FIR that was filed, a CBI inquiry was ordered. But look at what happened. Kuldeep Singh Sengar, for the longest time, kept on saying that these people, they don't matter, they are insignificant, I have done nothing. I remember distinctly that Sengar came to the SSP office here in Lucknow at 1 in the night, Ankita, and he dared the SSP to arrest him. Where was the SSP? The SSP said, I'm not at home. What can I do? That was the level of submissiveness on display from the government and the UP police when it came to Kuldeep Singh Sengar. So that was one case. The other, of course, case is the original gang rape case, the gang rape trial. This gang rape allegedly happened in 2017. The rape survivor says she was trying her best to get her case registered with the Unnao police. It was not done. She had to go to a court. Then a case was registered. That, of course, was later shifted to the CBI. The third case, of course, would be this car crash case that seems to be anything but an accident. But yes, of course, at the moment, it was a car crash that took place. A truck plowed into the car that this gang rape survivor and her family were traveling in. That trial will be shifted, that investigation and trial will be shifted to Delhi. And then there are two other cases that have to do with similar circumstances. So all trials now going to happen in Delhi. This is what the family has been saying. They do not want all of this to happen in Uttar Pradesh. They do not believe the government. They do not believe the police. The police and the government have done nothing, not in the last year, not in the last 24 hours, to reassure the survivor, her family, to reassure any one of us that they are serious about doing something. I mean, for God's sake, the Unnao SP yesterday was giving us a mathematical point about how he did not receive 35 letters from the gang rape survivor, how he received 25, and yet he acted on none.